got 11.
I rolled a 9.
That's why I usually use 2d20s. On the reroll.
Oh my.
Rerolls,
yeah. Can we reroll?
Yeah.
4.
Oh, who's first in that case?
So to go McNuggets, guest, myself.
Oh wait, I'm still 11. I have to reroll with force of law 9.
Right.
So the person who rolled 11 is first. And we rolled for a second roll in it. Wow, an 11. Ian, you rolled a 9 the first time, right?
What was that?
First time, right?
Yeah, free mulligan for the first time. And shift this back.
I'll keep this hand. Is that Zur Doomsday, I'm guessing?
Doomsday.
Alright, free 7.
Oh, fuck. What is this for?
It's not great, but I guess I'll fucks with it.
I'm going to 6.
Ew. 6?
Turn order again.
McNuggets, Pie, Ian.
I guess I got a quick 6. On the bottom. Oh, that's a terrible draw. Are you guys ready?
I'm good.
Oh my god, this is horrendous. Underground river and pass.
I go. Did you say pass?
Yep.
All right, draw for turn. City of Brass. I will ping myself for 1, go to 39. Tap for green. Guess Fintorn Elves.
You got it.
Pass turn.
Fintorn Elves, we're at top tier. Oh. Asking if that's Fiendhorn Elf.
Oh.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a Llanowar Elf, basically.
Yeah. Okay. End of your turn, Mystical Tutor.
Yeah, got it.
Ritual. On top, roll. Will be Urborg, Tomb of Yawgmoth. Pass Dark Ritual. Block for Necropole.
Okay, that's a good magic card.
Yep.
I guess I'm on 40. I will Necro for my hand on Necro 4. Go to 36 and say go.
Okay. Draw for turn. Play an island. Necropole. Go.
Untap. Upkeep. Draw for turn. Play Flooded Strands. Tap. Crack. Go to 38. Yep. Fetching. Plateau. Sphere.
Ooh. Damping Sphere. Damping Sphere is pay like cost one for each spell you cast after that.
Correct. And any
and if I
that would tap for more than two is just colorless instead.
Yeah, that's fine. I'm fine with that.
Yeah. I got nothing.
Pass turn.
On the turn, it's a bit more difficult now. Or I'm using a proxy. It's Conjurer's Bauble. It's just not
such a nice proxy. Conjurer's Bauble. What does that do?
In fact, for one, I can sack it, put up to one target card from my graveyard on the bottom of my library, and I draw a card.
That's fine.
You're good.
And after that, I will necro, like, my hand. Go to 33 and pass.
See, what can I do anything at the end of your turn? Negative. I'm just going to draw. Play an island. Whew, do I just keep the mana open right now? I think I do. Pass turn.
Untap. Upkeep. Draw for turn. Let's see. Woodland Cemetery tapped.
one card that stops him.
Let me think for a second. Tap two, paying one life for green. I'll cast Phyrexian Revoker.
Is the active abilities can't be activated?
Of a card that I choose, if it ETBs.
Of ETBs, oh, that's fine.
Okay. I got nothing.
Alright, so Revoker enters battlefield. I will name Necropotence.
Seems D's.
I can necro in response to ETB trigger.
You could, yes.
That's my next 10 step, but still. Cards, they're not gonna go into exile. Or does that just cover the pay one life thing?
So basically it's ETB triggers on the stack. So I'm naming Necropotence.
Yeah, I'm just asking, so once the Necropotence is revoked by the guy, does that just negate the pay one life ability? Nothing else, everything else is the same.
Yes, it's just the activated ability, pay one life.
Oh, that's pretty lame. Okay. Yeah, I'm gonna necro for like, Walker, Fiend Cornels. Do 20 cards.
Shit.
Oh, jeez.
All right.
Get them land stuff.
Make them have it. Move to attacks. Can't swing with him. I'll swing Thinhorn Helves at McNuggets. One damage. And that will be my turn. I pass.
No draw. Amazing.
You'll get 20 cards. I don't feel too bad.
Damning Sphere is really stopping him, so.
Pretty much. Gotta pray that there's like a Cyclonic Rift or something in there. For each spell, I need to pay one more.
So your first spell, normal CMC. The next spell is a plus one tax. Your third spell is plus two, colorless, etc., etc.
Mm-hmm. I'll tap three and cast a Shimmer Mirror.
Okay.
Okay.
A Shimmer Mirror, but probably gonna have to pay for the things that we put in.
Certainly helps.
Go to end step. Yeah, I'll go to end step. Vapor. Oh. Okay. To pay one for Mox Diamond.
Yep.
Discard this Bloodstained Mire. It's two more.
Yeah, next spell.
Oh, that's insane.
Plus two on it.
Anything about that? Ice Coop. I exiled all my shit.
Okay.
Is that it?
Yeah, I mean, there's no, I can't use Necro, I will have to exile like over 20 cards. I had like all my zero mana rocks in hand, which I couldn't play.
Ugh, that stinks. Draw. Alright, see if I can do something with this.
Would've been great.
Ancient Tomb. I will take two, go to 37, tap a blue, float one colorless, play Baral, and say go.
Untap. Upkeep, draw for turn.
Stinks I can't use my necroponents in this deck.
Let's see. Enter the battlefield, name an online card. Yeah, it doesn't target specific necropotents, so. What to play? And Baral's what, a 1/3?
Yep, he's 1/3. He's got a big butt.
Big old booty. I'm gonna play Savage Lands tapped. I'll attempt to cast black, pay one for black. 3/4, Twilight Prophet.
What does that do?
Flying with Ascend. It's a 2/4 at the beginning of my upkeep. If I have the City's Blessing, reveal the top card, put it into my hand. Each opponent loses X life. I gain X life equal to the card CMC.
We can do this. I will tap one blue and cast Memory Lapse, putting on top of your library.
Sure.
Trigger on Baral, I will draw a card, and then discard a card. I would discard Emrakul, the Promise End.
Alright.
Did I get shuffled back or no?
No.
I'll pass.
Oh, this card's dead in my hand. Stamping Sphere. Take two again. Go to 35. Play Thought Vessel.
Sure.
And then pass the turn.
What's that? Upkeep. Draw. Twilight Prophet. Play Cliff Chop Retreat. So I will let's do this. We'll tap black and white. I will attempt to cast Animate Dead.
Ooh. Animate Dead. I don't. Yeah. I'm going to counterspell that. You're not going to target the Emrakul.
Pretty much.
Oh, God. That's disgusting. Trigger on Baral. Draw.
Okay.
And then I will discard. Ooh, this is difficult. Discarding. Unstable.
I'll pay one for black. Black, 3/4. Cast Twilight Prophet.
That's good.
ETBs. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Do not have City's Blessing yet. Yeah, I'll pass turn after that. The life.
It's worth doing right now. Pass the turn, stop at your upkeep.
Alright. Untap. Upkeep.
I'm going to take two. Go to 33. I'm going to cast Mana Short, targeting you.
And what's that do?
All opponents tap their lands and empty your mana pool.
Opponent or all opponents?
All opponents.
Yeah.
I guess that's fine. Mana pool is empty.
Yep.
Go to draw. Play Scattered Groove. I now have Ascend. Get the sick ass City's Blessing token. Move to attacks. Swing Twilight Prophet at you for 2 in the air.
2 in the air?
Yep.
Take 2. Go to 31.
Pass turn.
Let's see here. So my next spell costs 1 more, right? Because I already casted a spell this turn, which is mana short.
His turn, then, yeah.
Well, that was on my turn. So, yeah, if you're casting this on my end step, it'll have +1 tax on it.
AKA be just regular CMC. Because it costs 1 less. So,
right.
Regular CMC. I don't know if this is worth it. Should I do that? Tap 2, cast into the royal, bouncing Damping Sphere to your hand.
Yep, no response.
Alright, yeah. Turn, untap, upkeep, draw. Okay. Let's see here. Take 3. Float 1 blue. So I'll take 2 from Ancient Tomb. Float a blue. Play Extraplanar Lens.
Yep.
Targeting this island. Still floating 1 blue. Use 3 of it to cast 4C.
And that card does...
Scry 4, then I draw 2.
Yeah, go for it.
I put 3 to the bottom and keep 1 on top. And I'll draw 2 cards. Misty Rainforest for land. Crack it. Go to 28. Go get an island. Tap 2, floating a blue, brainstorm.
You got it.
Those are okay magic cards. This can go on top. This can go on top. Let's see here. Go to end step, pass turn.
Untap. Upkeep.
Yep.
Twilight Prophet triggers on the stack. Reveal.
Mm-hmm.
Foothills. Take no damage. So this goes to hands. Draw per turn. Let's play Wooded Foothills. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I will crack, paying 1, go to 36.
Mm-hmm.
Grab a bayou. You have, 2 mana available?
Yep. Cards in hand?
So currently have 3 cards in hands.
Okay.
Let's do... tap white, white. 1, 2, 3. Paying one. Attempt to cast Elish Norn.
Well, that's a good Magic the Gathering card. I got double mana. Don't care. Resolves.
Okay. And I'm at 36. Next. Move to attacks. Swing with Twilight Prophet and Revoker.
Yep.
So taking 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Go to 20.
Yeah, 2 on the ground, 2 in the air. After that, I'll pass turn.
Draw. Okay. Play my little island for the turn. Hellish Norn, you say?
Yes, sir.
Going to tap 4, floating 1 blue. I'm going to tell you how bad this brainstorm I just messed up it, because let's see here. Going to 1 to improvise using 1 blue for 3. Whirly intervention for 3.
For 3, and it puts an artifact directly into play, correct?
Yes.
Yeah.
Whirl of intervention.
3 or less.
You got it.
Okay. Vidalkin Shackles?
Yep.
Let's see here. What power is Elish Norn?
Is a 4/7.
4/7. 4/7, so I can take it. Power's less than or equal. No, I can't take it. Less than.
I'm gonna go after them, guys. Have fun.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Later, man.
One, two, three, four. Actually, I can take it because I have 4 islands. Because it's power less than or equal to the number of islands I have. She's a 4/7, right?
Correct.
All right, so I'll tap 2. Vidalkin Shackles, Elish Norn. This dice will be my Elish Norn. Cool. Pass turn.
Tap. Upkeep. Twilight Prophet on the stack. Flip. Engineer's Plague. So you'll take 3 damage.
They don't, I control Elish Norn so they don't die.
Yeah, yeah.
How big is, your creatures?
2/4. Well, these two are dead, yeah.
Okay, makes sense.
Yeah. But yeah, Engineer's Plague. So you'll take 3, I'll gain 3.
Alright, I'll go to 17.
This comes to hand. Draw for turn. Tap 2. Attempt to cast Damping Sphere.
I will take 2 damage, float 2 mana. So I'll go to 15, cast Rewind. Counter target spell, I untap 4 lands.
Response. 1 red. We'll cast Pyroblast.
That's a good magic card. Still have one. I don't have one floating. Man, I'm bad at this game. Yeah, you got it.
Alright. Damping Sphere resolves. Next, we'll go. How do we want to do this? So I'll tap three, pay two Phyrexian mana, cast Birthing Pod.
Ooh, that's a good card. Yeah, that's good.
What do I search for? I guess just move to attacks. I'll swing two in the air.
Yep, go to 13.
And I'll pass turn. I'll be right back.
Got it. Island. Man, I gotta pay for this. Damping Sphere. Oh, if only I was out too. Jesus Christ. Alright, that's fine. So Damping Sphere. So my island's tap for colorless only.
Yes, that's correct.
Huh. Should have floated some mana. Can't cast any of my spell. Yeah, GG. I can't do anything because I had Psycrypt in my hand and I was like, wait a minute, I can't play these cards. Yeah, because I should have left one blue mana open for Swan Song. So I was going to Swan Song the Pyroblast.
I guess you could have got there with Elish Norn beats.
I could have. Yeah, but I could have just got pinged in the air because I have no flyers.
Let's see what's on top. Crop rotation. I don't know if I have any lands that get you. Yeah. Good games, man.
Good games. Good games.
Yeah, I think I was just going to do that one quick one, but feel free to add me if you're around later in the week or some shit.
Oh yeah, I gotta build my, I'm waiting for my car to come in. I'm trying to have Bro Storm.
Nice.
But I think your deck ruins Bro Storm. I don't know, your deck ruins a lot of Storm decks in the format.
Yeah, it's horrible versus creature decks, but any of the kind of combo shit, it does alright versus.
Oh yeah, of course. Alright man, I'll add you.
Alright. I'll check you later.
Thanks, man, for the game.
Yep. Peace.